Volunteers are launching a new effort aimed at improving school attendance by helping chronically late and absent students get to class on time. Eyewitness News reporter Andrew Adamson is covering schools now with the Providence Mobile Newsroom.
A new school year is set to start at Fogarty Elementary very soon. For some kids, getting to class can be kind of a challenge. A new program, though, is set to make that a little bit easier for them.
Tanisha Miller's mom lives on Ocean Street, just a couple blocks from Fogarty Elementary. But during the school year, her little sisters have a tough time getting to class because of her mom's arthritis.
She can't walk them to school every day, and I got my own children, and I can't take them back and forth to school.
Unfortunately, that's a common problem at Fogarty. The result? Dozens of students are chronically absent, meaning they missed at least 10% of last school year. So the Providence Children's Initiative decided to take action. With feedback from families, the organization created this attendance map. The hope is that it'll help officials pinpoint what issues affected certain areas.
It was always something to do with health or transportation. It was something that we felt that we needed to take a look at.
The map showed that the majority of chronically absent students lived within a mile of their school and weren't eligible to ride the bus. They hope a new volunteer program will be the solution. It's called the Walking School Bus, but it isn't a bus at all. Volunteers will supervise children as they walk to school.
The idea is that a parent will just drop them at a set stop, meet the volunteer there, leave the kid at the stop with the volunteer, and then they'll keep going along the route.
Six families have already committed to the Walking School Bus program, and Miller hopes her mom will sign her sisters up as well.
This is an opportunity to really give her a break this year because we did have someone who used to walk them every day.
And the goal is to expand this pilot route as more families sign up. With the Providence Mobile Newsroom, Andrew Adamson, Eyewitness News.